Right now, one of the biggest features of Bitcoin as well as other cryptocurrencies is the fact that they can theoretically be mined in a decentralized manner. There's a reason we say theoretically, and it's because mining is tending towards becoming more and more centralized with the development of ASICs, mining pools, and mining farms. Mining pools and mining farms are pretty straightforward, and they're usually run by a single entity. ASICs, on the other hand, are also centralized, but in a sense that ASICs can cost a lot of money. And this means that only people with enough capital can acquire them, centralizing the mining process. We're going to attempt to address the problem of mining centralization by considering the design of the underlying hash puzzle and see if there's any way we can redesign it. Here's a quick reminder on what properties a cryptographic puzzle should have. A puzzle should be hard enough to solve, but easy to verify. In Bitcoin, finding a nonce is incredibly difficult, but verifying that a particular nonce is correct is much, much easier. The difficulty should be adjusted to account for changes in mining technology, such as the development of ASICs. In Bitcoin, the difficulty is adjusted to every 2 weeks. You need a solving rate proportional to computational power, meaning that the difficulty reflects the amount of hash power in the network. A puzzle should be progress-free, meaning that finding a hash does not make it easier to find the next hash. Every solution is independent of the previous ones. Lastly, you need a pseudo-randomly generated puzzle. And the puzzle that we're dealing with in Bitcoin is described as a partial hash pre-image puzzle. You don't have to find the exact pre-image of the hash, as long as you have the prerequisite number of leading zeros.